So today we're gonna be talking about what's in my doggy bag. Here is actually a bag that I borrowed from my brother, and we've been using it for Frankie's bag for forever now, since I've gotten him. And there's a lot of essentials in this bag, and it's boring stuff really, but it really helps you with whatever you're doing throughout your day, whether it's going for a hike, whether it's just camping, whether it's going to the park, whether it's going for a walk and staying hydrated. Everything is in here, and this is what we use on like a daily basis. This is nothing too special, so it's nothing insane. It's just hopefully this will help you with whatever is in your bag or whatever you want to be essential in yours. So to start it off, we're going to start off with some pretty boring stuff, and it's in the pocket right here. So a lot of people don't think this is too important, but this is a tick remover. These are two little tick removers, and one is for bigger ticks and one is for smaller ticks. And basically, when you're out there in the woods, you don't want to give a tick a chance. So these are the two options that I have, and I just keep this stored away in the front pouch of my bag because it's safe. The next thing I have in that bag is for you, actually. It's for the owner, and this is off. This is super important. You have to get the deep woods one. If you live anywhere near woods, we live in Canada, so woods are insane and mosquitoes are even worse. Just on the side pouch here, we have the guppy. Now, I'm sure you've all seen these before. It's not very big. It's simply a water bottle that you can screw off. You can fill it with water. You can screw this back on, and then when you flip it over, you can just push the water right out and then they can go for a drink. Not a huge fan of the fact that it's all plastic, but it is a pretty essential item, and we reuse it every single day whenever we go to the dog park or on a hike. It really, really comes in handy. And this clip right here actually really helps it to stay on while we're on our hikes, because sometimes water bottles fall out, they pop out, you never know what's gonna happen to them. This helps it stay on. And then there's also a little hoop right here where you can clip on to a carabiner or whatever you might need. So now it's time to go inside the bag. So right off the bat, it's more hydration. So this is a product that I actually found on Amazon, and basically it comes with two carabiners on the side, and clipped to those carabiners are those water bottles that everyone has seen. Every dog owner has these, the one that's just pop out like this, and you can put food, you can put water in it, and they're pretty standard. They don't last forever, so the more you pop them out, the more you wear and tear them, just like anything else. But what's cool about this water bottle is that it's not just a water bottle. See, you can notice that there's two spouts right here, and there's clips on along the side. And I was very nervous that things were just gonna fall out and spill, but there's actually like a little suction. There's rubber on the inside, and that keeps like all the suction to the cup. And you can fill either side with either food or water. And then there is a little separator here that helps you pour your food and your water and make sure you don't get any water in your food. We haven't been on any hikes recently, but we definitely will. And this will be the first thing that we pack because it's gonna be essential for food and water and just making sure Frankie stays really, really healthy and hydrated on the hike. Next up, we have a very, very essential item for every dog. This is Frankie's new leash. We just got him this. It is a green leash from Wilder Dog. I don't know how you want to say it. There's a carabiner clasp right here that goes right onto his harness, and a nice loop. And it's all made out of hiking rope. But the only thing that I have to say about this leash so far is that you have to have some rough hands. So if you have a dog that pulls, you're gonna get used to feeling this on your hands. It is a tough rope, but it is a rope that will never break. And then alongside attached that, I just have it going through a hoop right here, is our earth-rated green poop bags, where they're decomposable and everything like that. And well, you've seen these. These are just standard poop bags. We just have it attached to the leash right here. And this is I believe a 5-foot leash. Next up, let's go to what we attach that leash to. We have two harnesses here. These are amazing harnesses. One, we got these because of Frankie's brothers. Frankie's brothers both have these, and it's really cute that when they get together, they're wearing the same thing. But other than that, it's an amazing harness. The reason why we have two, Frankie was growing, and I didn't realize that I didn't open this one up the way. This is the small, and then this is the medium. So whenever this one gets wet, we put this one on. Sometimes when we're going on a hike, this one gets dirty. There's always this one. It's always important to just have doubles of the most essential things that you need in the bag. I'll make a video on this one later, but the real reason why we really like these RC Pets ones, because it simply goes over their head like this and then under their body and clips like this. There's no getting him to put his leg through a loop and make him uncomfortable. It's simply this goes over his head and clips around his body, and there's a clip on the top, and then there's a loop at the front. So if they're a puller, they get jabbed this way. And then if we're in a dog situation where this one's gonna hurt him, I put it to this. Or if we're just going for a hike, I put it to this and make sure he's safe. And then there's a handle on the back. And we have two of those just to be. Next up, we'll go to something a little bit more fun, but I'm sure all of you have seen before. This is the Chuck It. This is Frankie's second favorite toy. We only have two outside toys right now. We're using the felt ball right now, which I do wanna switch that to the rubber ball, because this one is gonna get nasty. We've only really used this once or twice because he likes his, well, I can't say it because he's sitting beside me, he's gonna get really excited. He likes his other one the best, but we've all seen this toy, so I'm gonna get rid of this. This right here, folks, is the money maker. Boom. This is the Kong Red Frisbee. I believe this is the medium or the large one, and it's flexible, and he's bitten on this for ages. Every time he takes it and he bites on it like this. He is currently right beside us right now because he wants to play so bad, but this is an amazing Frisbee. The only complaint about it is that it does not float in the water. So if it goes in the water, it's sinking very quickly, and you have a sad dog. But other than that, it's pretty easy to throw, and it goes pretty far. Goes a good distance, and they are able to catch it. It's a little bit more difficult to catch because it's a little bit flimsy, so when it hits their mouth it kind of bends, but it's safer for them. Next, we're gonna jump into the food portion. I have to go pick him up some more treats right now, but Frankie really likes the Fruitable Skinny Minis. This is the apple bacon flavor, and yep, there's only a few in there, as you can see. These are soft bake and grain free, and he really likes them. And then the other thing that we always do, we always make sure we have extra food. No matter what it is, we always want to make sure that we have some sample bag of food. So right now, we just went to a dog event, and I guess this is called Natural and Delicious. It's a pumpkin formula, and it's just so if we're ever traveling, if we're in the car and he hasn't eaten for a while and we're stuck in traffic or we're on a hike, this is very important to have in your bag, because as much as you need the energy while hiking, they do as well, and it's just for their safety. So we just keep any sample bag that we have on. And then finally, a towel. We keep this towel. This is off like an Amazon towel. I'm sure everyone's seen it. It's probably in loads of PetSmarts. It's just a simple towel for wiping their paws before they get in their car. Maybe they need to dry off a little bit. Maybe you've been throwing his amazing Frisbee that also collects goose poop in the park. Maybe you get a little goose poop on your hand. You can wipe it on here. It's just important to have. And that is what is always in our dog bag.
If you want to see more detailed videos on what's actually in the bag, then we can definitely do that as well. The one thing that wasn't shown was his, what am I trying to say? Doggy belt for the car. I think it's really important to have a belt in the car, bless you, in the car for them, because there's too many horror stories of driving in a car accident and the dog flies through the window shield. So both him and I are trying to be safe, and you should keep your dog just as safe as you are. The next few reviews we're gonna be making on the harnesses and the new leash, because I think there's a lot to be said about those two, and then we can make one on his favorite toy or whatever you wanna see, whatever this man, when he stops licking himself.
Yep,
we're waiting for you, bud.
Okay.
Whatever you want to see that's in our bag, if you want to see a deeper review on it or lengthier review, make sure you leave a comment down below. And make sure you what, Frankie? Like and subscribe. Thank you. Okay. Bye. It didn't work.